to do more on that, and we have now a special envoy as well on religious freedom, which is Lord Ahmed, our foreign office minister. Part of my visit is about just talking to people about that and what we're doing, and we've just had a great lunch with some people to get their insights on that. Part of it is also to really look at the women and girls agenda and really how we, unless we can really empower them, unless they're able to stay in school, unless they have more control over the choices they make in life, we're never going to meet the sustainable development goals. They are the margin of victory. So one thing that we really now want to do in the department is create some bigger partnerships with organisations that perhaps we haven't done much with in the past. Faith communities in the UK are a big focus for us, so we're looking to see not just what we can do with my budget, but with our technical expertise, our creative law, the City of London, all of these other things that we have to offer. And our faith groups are part of that, and making those connections between our communities in the UK and communities who are wanting to assist in the developing world. So it's a bit of a sort of different approach, but I think the right approach for what we want to do. And I think in particular it would be helpful just to hear about how we might support the common agenda that we have. We want to protect women and girls. We want to step up our work on things like family planning in Africa in particular, because I think without that we aren't going to be able to really get where we want to be. Part of that, not all of it, but part of it, we will have common ground on. So we're trying to end FGM, we're trying to stop child marriage. We have 800 women and girls die every day because in childbirth, because they're largely because they are too young. And so really trying to lever everything we have to try and get change to happen. It would just be great to get a bit more of an insight into how we might help each other on those agendas.
You also had an experience in Romania, I read.
Yes.
I was
pressured in Chancellor as well.
I organized the visit of the Pope John Paul II in Romania, the first visit in an Orthodox country.
What year?
I was there in 1999.
Yes.
I was there very friendly in the Patrick, and at the Cardinal Palace, my friend was in I apologize because my English is not so good, so that's why.
In case of
being
our ambassador.
No, so, firstly, I would like to underline that as a pontifical candidate for life, one of the first my engagement was to invite to take part in the academy people in the council also of the other Christian confessions and religions, other religions. And, I asked to the Archbishop of Canterbury to send someone, and one of his scientists, Miguel, is a member appointed by the Pope to take part of this great honor of the